Thank you, Senator. I recognize Senator from the 37th. Senator, you have.
Thank you, Mr. President. I had the honor to serve with Speaker David Ralston for 18 years in the House. And I want to tell a very, very short story about how we became Speaker, because it speaks to the challenge all of us have to have the courage of our convictions. Before David Ralston became the Speaker of the House, he was the chairman of the Judiciary Noncivil Committee. And the fair, balanced approach he took to that, the way he ran committee meetings, is step by step, word for word, exactly how I endeavored to chair hearings when I chair them. I know that Senator from the 30th served with us there as well. Senator from the 30th was a very good friend of Speaker Ralston's as well. But what I wanted this body to hear, and what I wanted Georgians to hear, was that in 2009 we had a leadership crisis in the House of Representatives. I won't be too detailed in how I describe it, but the leadership crisis manifested itself with a leadership in the House that was erratic, not bringing honor in our chamber in personal and professional ways. And David Ralston, as chairman of the Judiciary Non-Civil Committee, had it pretty good. It would have been very easy for him to stay where he was and continuing to serve and contribute as a House member, as a chairman. But in the 2009 session, he took it upon himself to stand against the existing Speaker of the House in a leadership challenge, because he believed that the House should operate with a level of dignity and trust and substance in what we did. And David Ralston stood against our existing Speaker, lost the leadership race, lost his chairmanship, was banished from his office in 132 in his very meaningful position, and sent across the street without a chairmanship in a office in the legislative office building overlooking a dumpster, because he believed that the dignity of the House and our leadership mattered that much. As things changed, as things progressed through the course of the next year, and having taken that stand in 2009, being willing to sacrifice what was good for him politically for what he thought was best for the state, the House in 2010 honored him with him making him Speaker of the House, which, again, the service we talk about, the service we think about with Chairman formerly Chairman, then Speaker Ralston's well known across our state. But what allowed that to happen was a lesson for all of us to have the courage of our convictions, that even when things don't look politically beneficial to us and things sometimes seem impossible, sometimes those fights are the fights worth having. And I'd like to thank my friend David Ralston for having that fight. As a young third-term member, watching all that go down, knowing there needed to be a change, needing somebody that had the stature and experience to stand up and do something about it, he was the one with the courage of his convictions to lose a chairmanship, lose his potential for influence, to do what's best for the state of Georgia. And he was rewarded by our members less than a short year later to be our Speaker. So with that, I just wanted to say this was not a position that was handed to him, didn't come to him easily, but it came to him ultimately from the courage of his convictions to do what's best for the state, what was best for our House, and best for the citizens that we serve across the state of Georgia. I wanted to just say that in honor of my friend David Ralston. I know there's many that would have fond things to say. But with that, Mr. President, I yield the floor.